Okay, so this kind of ends this talk. So we've been flying all over this planet. We've been covering a lot of grounds. I hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you fly again with us. We just arrived at our final destination and the temperature outside is -1 degrees. I kind of hope also that it kind of frustrates you because I've only like mentioned the few ideas of different fields and I want you to go further. That's kind of the message here. It's go further because these things are extremely cool and I've just kind of mentioned the tip of the iceberg. Which leads me to talk about Science4All. So Science4All is a website I've launched less than a year ago. It's a website of quality popular science. And there are three things you can do to enjoy and help Science4All improve. Basically reading articles, sharing articles, and writing articles. And I'm going to give you one reason to do each of these. Now, why should you read articles? Now, Science4All is a website which deals with a lot of different subfields of mathematics and science. And by learning about other fields, you'll have new insights, new ideas about how to approach problems. And a lot of the new ideas of the 20th century really came from the interface, the interdisciplinarity between different fields. And if you want to be in this sort of innovation process, you have to have at least an image of what the other fields are like and what they talk about. Okay, now why should you share articles? Well, there are plenty of reasons why to do so. I'm just going to mention that today we live in democracy. The research we're doing is funded by the people, and we owe to these people, to show them why they are giving us money to do the things we do. And well, a lot of people would say, well, obviously we're providing new science which makes new stuff and you can see the consequences. But the reason why we do science is not because of that. It's because science is awesome, because there's so much thing to learn and new perspectives to have and cool ideas to discover. And that's the sort of spirit people need to be in to really enjoy science. So that's why we should have to propagate more of these ideas. And sharing articles is one way of doing that. And finally, a reason why to write articles. Well, I can give you plenty once again, but I'm just going to give you one. When you write an article, especially if you write about a topic that's near what you're actually doing in your research, you have to boil down to what's essential to what you're doing. You have to get back to the fundamental reasons why you're doing the research you do. And this gives you a new insight into how to approach the problems you do. And I'm pretty sure you're going to be learning a lot about your own research by trying to talk about it in a different way. And if you do write articles, I just want to say, there's one rule I want you to follow. I'm going to conclude with this last sentence. Need to make it simple, make it cool. Thank you.
Is there any questions?
Can be about anything.
Yeah, don't be shy.
Other things or mathematics or whatever you want. I can cut it from the video if you don't want to be on YouTube.
Yeah, because we have to talk in the microphone and it's... yeah, we can cut it.
No question?
No?
About Gödel's incompleteness theorem. The way I understood it, I don't know if it's right or wrong, but you could probably tell me. I understood it as in a certain framework we can solve some problems easily, but in this same framework there are problems that we cannot solve. But if we use another framework, the problems we could not solve in the other framework are solved easily, let's say, but there are the easy problems in the other framework are not solved easily. Is this a way of seeing it?
So what you're talking about is the first theorem of incompleteness by Gödel. what I was mentioning is the second theorem. Now, regarding this fourth theorem, now it's very weird because in a mathematical framework, the mathematical framework needs to be able to talk about what it means for a proof to be right. And it's possible that within a framework, there's no proof for a particular sentence, which we call, and this problem, the theorem which cannot be proved, is called undecidable. And the reason why you cannot prove it is sometimes because there are not the right language, there's not the right language in the mathematical framework to prove it. And so you can think of a more general theory which would apply it or explain it or provide a proof at least to this. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. And I had a second question. Is there a link between the incompleteness theorem and physics? Like, why, if we know that, example, mathematics are incomplete, why are we still searching for a unified theory of everything?
That's a very interesting question. Obviously, I'm not going to be able to provide the right answer, but I can tell you what I think. It's very troubling, this idea. And one way of looking at it is that maybe mathematics is not the right, at least mathematics as we know it, is not the right right framework to think about the universe. Because if we use the mathematics we're using to describe the universe, then it means that there are things in the universe which are undecidable. And what it means for universe to be undecidable, it means that something is not really happening in the universe. So maybe the mathematical framework we're using is not right for describing the universe. And one way of looking at it is one of the assumptions, for instance, the big reason why Gödel's theorem applies is the fact that the set of whole numbers exist, which kind of leads to the fact that infinity exists. And as far as I know, there's no proof that there's no reason why infinity should exist in our universe. Maybe there's no infinity in the universe. And if there's no infinity in the universe, like there's no continuum of space, that's one of the weird things. If space is not continuous, then maybe we can describe it with another language which doesn't involve the set of whole numbers. In this case, the universe could be complete. There would be no incompleteness. So maybe that's a way of answering. Maybe that's the reason why any of the theory we make, because they involve derivability or continuity, stuff that are really about infinity. Maybe that's why they cannot describe the universe. Well, it's at least one reason why.
More questions?
Okay.
Thank you.